Hey guys, Doug here. I've got these Spim08HP cells. I built a couple of packs with them. These are 7S. And I wanted to do a capacity test. So, sorry for the movement on the camera. I am using my tiny tripod. So I want to do a capacity test on this using my iCharger X8. This is a great tool to use for capacity testing. So what I'm going to do is I don't have an adapter made for this. So I'm just going to kind of whip something up here that I can use. These have BMSs on them as well. Yeah, what I really need is like just a piece of tape or piece of plastic. I can wrap this in plastic. All right, I got that one plugged in. So now what we'll do is we'll just take this here. That like that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set it and I'm gonna make sure it is charged fully up. I'm gonna set it to 7S. One lithium ion. Be wary how much amperage your pack has. And I screwed it up. Because I had it set to balance and I shouldn't not balance. Alright, so now we're doing a top off charge. At 4.3 amps. It's almost fully charged. These things have been charged for probably 6 months and they've held their charge very well. I'm gonna let this charge and then I'll be back. Alright guys, so we have charged it all the way up. Let's see if I can get that to I'll put it on discharge. Yeah,
It only discharges at a max of 5 amps. So now it is running the discharge test. But let me correct myself. I said it'll discharge at a max of 5 amps. And it looks like this pack is only pushing out a max of 1.77 amps. Or 50 watts. So I'll let this run and then we'll come back with the results.
Alright guys, so this finished. I cleared out the amp hours by accident. It was 6.079 capacity left in these cells. It went, you can see here, it's registering 2.37. It went until the BMS cut it out for being at low voltage. So the low voltage disconnect turned on. So what I'm going to do I've got to jump start this in order for it to charge again. Trying to think how I'm going to do that. Boost converter. Alright, so I'm going to jump it from this battery pack to this battery pack. So going to use my resistor to wake it up. As you see, I'm holding it there. So now we'll see if that was sufficient enough. To wake it up and use the charger now. Yep, we're at 24 volts. All right, so now we're charging. Watts. So I'm going to let that charge and then we'll be back. See if the charge cycle and the discharge cycle were roughly the same.
Hey guys. Back here. I was having some problems getting this charged up with my i8. I needed to create an adapter that'll work for these packs. So what I did is I took my boost converter and I charged it up. It's at 28.88 volts. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rerun the capacity test. I wasn't happy with the first results of the i8, so I wanted to double check it. So I'm going to get set up to use this to rerun the capacity test, and we'll get started on that. All right, so I got this set up in 28.8 volts. On here, I got this all done.
Let me clear it out. Let's clear it out. So now what I will do, take the discharge up the 1 point. All right, got the discharge set to 5 amps. Watts. I have to move my light above me so that it doesn't glare in the videos. I'm gonna let this run, see how many amp hours and watt hours this tool pulls out of this pack. On my i8, I got 6 amp hours. So I'll be back when this is finished to show you the results. Just again, this is 7S pouch cells. They're rated at 8 amp hours. I want to see what capacity is left in these. Alright guys, this is finished and it looks like the i8 was right. I got 6.49 amp hours out of this pack. So now, I'm going to have to test the rest of the packs, and I'm going to build a 24 volt portable power box to keep in my electric car, my Nissan Leaf. So, yeah, I'm going to get this charged back up. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll have more videos coming soon.